Amen.
Because God said all things were made by Him.
Amen.
And you will hear me when I pray.
Amen.
I want to tell you, if you live a righteous life, God is an open towards your prayer.
Amen.
Stop begging and complaining. Remember the promise is that He became poor so that I and you could be rich today. He says the earth is the Lord and the fullness thereof. And that is for they that dwell therein. He can't go back to heaven with dashing and dashing bush. Oh God, let me leave all that in peace. The things that are spiritual, spiritual.
Amen.
Dashing, dashing, bush and money and motor car and houses for me down here.
Come on, come on, come on.
Blessed are the meek, for they shall inherit.
That's right, that's right.
I said, that is for me, why I'm here.
Amen.
If you're not in Him, you can't drive motor car because you say, I have things for you. Eyes have not seen it. The message ready now. Yes. Let us go in the Philippians. Philippians will speak to me first. The way it is, over and quite into this. Philippians, chapter 3 and verses 13.
Yeah.
Minister, for the minister, Kevin, and all the other ministers. Come on, it's not time to wait for nobody anymore. It's not time to wait for anybody. Let me tell you something. It has people that are pulling us back. Come on, come on. You have to decide now that you forget certain things. You must forget certain people. And you understand what we say? You must go make them happy. Comprehend you. Go make them lock you down. Go make them lock you down. Paul says, you see, it's 2:20, I will not be apprehended. No one is holding me down this year.
Nothing. It comes to stay.
kill you, I destroy you. Somebody say, I'm forgetting today. I ain't going home without knowing who I know I am. They could say who I think I am, but I know who God says I am. Let them who are walking in power.
Come on.
Are we here? I say I'm walking. For too many years, they hold me down, bump me, and tie me up. I tell them some things about myself. They cut me here off my head. They tie me two hands, and they blind me, and they decide to mock me. But I thank God, my hair go back. I'm going to kill all those things that were killing me all the time. I'm going to push it down.
I reach for unto those things which are before.
Oh God.
I press towards the man for the price of the high call of God in Christ Jesus.
There is a price for and the old is back. You can get the price. You got to press to the ground. You need to touch. If you don't press to the ground, sometimes you will get bashed. When you press in, you will get spit on. You will get kicked out. But keep on pressing. When God gave me that message, God gave me that message, counting down, coming down. That's why I thank God for running the Bible class for me in December. But then God said, the time now, the very first thing he told me to tell the children, we as Christians, we're making errors. He asked who could understand his error. But then I want to turn to him. David said, even though I ain't understanding, but cleanse thou me.
Yes, sir.
From some secret faults.
Yes,
church, you're hiding behind lies.
Where?
You're hiding behind backbiting.
Where?
You're hiding behind blaspheming.
Where?
You're hiding behind unthankfulness.
Yes.
You're hiding and I'm looking like if you're holy, but you are holy at all. There is a form.
Come on, come on,
I said there is a form, but your hand bitter.
Come on, go ahead.
And the word of God says, if you have a bitter heart, Jesus can want you. Because I learned there was a man by the name, and he was a witchcraft kind of man.
Yeah.
And his name was Philip, Simon the sorcerer, sorry. And then after that, he went and got baptized too. He wanted to do the works of God. He wanted the will of God. But when God gave everybody else, the blessing said today in the passing me. Oh God, the man with the bitter heart also went for the blessing. And God put it, let me tell you something. God put it in the bishop's heart to tell the bitter heart man, you see you, your heart is in a bitter place. God didn't tell him that. God tell who he put to run the show to tell you that your heart is in a bitter place.
Sorry.
Read some read. Let us therefore, as many as be perfect, be thus minded. And yet,
we need to be perfect. In time, we need to be perfect. Brother, let me close my Bible because you're reading. And today, I can't preach for long today. But I'm telling you, if I ain't doing nothing, I sure forget it. The things that I'm here. Children have things. God didn't change.
Yeah.
Jesus said change it and you can change it.
Come on, come on. Who's that true?
Don't try to change things that you can't change. If you paint it and sun hit the paint after a while it will raise up, scale up and up. Don't try. Who I think that is.
I am one who know what God sent me here to do. I know how He sent me here to live. And I know, you remember the days, child. You remember when I and you used to go out and eat and drink and have a good time. And you say, Pastor, Bishop is the best in the world. Who I think I is? You forget it now. Because you choose to do what you want to do. You choose to do where you want to say. You choose to go where you want to go. And now I don't know why, because I am still the person with love. Are you understand what I'm saying, church? If you don't know who I know who I am. I am still the person with the hands stretched out looking to forgive you because God tell me to forgive you. And I asked a question, I'm tired when you say okay, I'm tired. I said 7 times, you say no, it's 70 times. Are you understanding? I know who I am. I'm walking in miracle. I'm walking in power. If they don't know who they is, they will remain in the back because I'm forgetting now.
Come on.
And I'm reaching. And I'm reaching to the mark. To Jesus Christ, because it's about a higher call. Not only that, Timothy. When you forget and you reach, is then now the problems will come, so you have to press more and more and more. You got to press more.
Yes.
I say you have to press.
Yes.
This church business is to press on.
Yes.
And never stop pressing on.
Yes.
And you understand what it is?
Yes.
Why are you here in the church?
Yes.
Church, I don't want to be responsible for you. I have to tell you the truth.
Yes.
Responsible for my sons and daughters, I have to tell them the truth. Thou shalt not steal. And there's a damn thief son or daughter in the teeth. It have things out. I have to tell the children the truth, which is all here. I have to tell them to continue to remember. Thou art the Lord thy God, who has brought you out of the land of Egypt and out of your bondage that you were in. Are you understand? If we share blessing and blessing move from one
somebody to remain with one. Because it's two in a meal grinding. Blessing will choose one side. Because we speak about blessing and you hate me today because I'm telling the truth about blessing. But we have been things we talked about before. Reason.
For I dare you record that if it had been possible, you would have plucked out your own eyes.
But if it were possible, you'd have plucked out your own eyes and give me your eyes. Reason.
You have given them to me.
Are we there, church? What's my God? That's why my God tell me to tell the church, not your trust in man.
Amen.
Because some people just drawn to him with their mouth. They honor him with their lips, but they don't have no heart. They're teaching you to get what they want from you. And sooner or later you tell them that's not the way to go. I want you to go back deeper and throw your net and catch for yourself. Because I want you to become fishers of men. I don't want you to stay begging to catch.
And I therefore become your enemy.
Oh my God! You promised me all these things. I don't know that church. But let me tell the church something before my voice leave. Then be back there for 2:20. So I'm betting it now. But let me tell you something more. Christian people, forget the things that are behind. And you go to Peter now, Brother
James. Yes.
First Peter. Let them know that all the prayer that we pray, the eyes of the Lord is on the right, and his ears are open to what we pray. And who could harm you when God? Some things, the only way to be blessed, you got to forget. Come on, church. Let me tell you something. I ain't giving the bishop a thing you have already. But God ain't giving you nothing like it. I remember last year I said, this sister. When the word of God says she's a weaker link, I'm not taking everything she said. I will get it. I will tell she was right. And the argument has run a little bit. Even though it was until 6 o'clock, I just make sure when that comes, because she is doing. Because she has to sleep in peace. And the next day I start giving back again. Because I take the word of God serious. Don't make you sleep with it. Oh, when she gets past that back again, no matter how you miss your win, you wasn't winning. I say you have a purse.
Yeah.
And you have to get it right in them. Because they become the weaker link. And you have to make sure that they get the right link. Then I never said to beat them, kick them, spit on them, I said talk to them.
And his ears are open unto their prayers.
Christian, pray! Pray, Christian, pray! God! 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 Blessed are they that pray and mourn! For God said, I will comfort you. When you have your problems, and you're crying out, and you're mourning, and you're weeping, don't fight no battle that is not belongs to you. God said that battle ain't belongs to you. It belongs to me. Let me tell you something. If God takes 21 days to come, he will keep you alive for 21 days. If he takes 40 days to come, he will keep you alive for 40 days. You may not be feeling well, but you will make it. This is what Christian talk is about. God says, I will give the angel charge over thee to keep thee. And let me tell you, that's why I'm telling you today. If God will reach in time, his angel will keep you. Oh God, I'm telling you something. And you understand that? I remember Sister Ruth and her husband as I look back there. They come to me and I say, they used to give me something. And then they come and they say, Bishop, God put them in spirit. That every month that we will give you this. And they kept on and kept on. And look at them. I said, when you bless you, we are asking you for your money. But I ask you for your money. I'm just telling you there are blessings in many ways. Respect is a blessing. Thanksgiving is a blessing. Unholiness is a curse. Unthankfulness is a curse. Oh God, telling somebody thanks is a blessing. Saying sorry is a blessing. That's why last year he told me to tell the church, remember not to forget, and don't forget to remember. Read some me.
But the face of the Lord is against them that do evil.
So we are worrying about. God sent his word and it didn't come here to go back for it. It come here to accomplish what it was sent for. And he said, only with an eye shall thou behold and see the reward of the wicked, because he gave it the angel charge. We will live long enough to see them fall right in front of us. What I'm trying to tell you, you people that love food, watch what you're talking on food. Phone will set you up.
If I curse you bad, 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 and disrespect you, man to man, you will have nothing on me. But if I disrespect you on the phone, and you know how to take me, I'm telling you, church and church teaching and you're not listening, so you're calling and you're telling a friend what you tell you and when he tells you, let me tell you that same thing could come and go on to you. Face to face, they have no record. All the record mashup is CD now. And how they call it? iPad. And what did I say? So you could use your mouth still and get away free. But these things you're doing and feel your bad. And you call a next one and you call a next one. Oh boy. Long time with the Fred card. But now, it's griffin. And to me, it's something better when you defeat you. No, I don't think it. Even defeat you.
Amen.
Amen. So God looking at us, is that your life? And He's listening to us, is that your life? But the ungodly are not like that. They are like a chaff with the wind driving away. Their body shall not stand in the congregation of the righteous. Get it right? Who I think I am? I know who I am. I'm going to live right, walk right, and talk right. Read.
And who is he that will harm you? If you be followers of that which is good.
You tell me. If anybody could interfere with you. You see, the reason why you're getting hurt is because you're trying to change him and you're trying to change him. But if you forget him and you forget him, and you're reaching now. I say you're going to reach now to that MacBook and you're pressing on. Let me tell you something. Paul said, when I started to run and I fainted by the way for the things I ought to do. I couldn't do it. And the things I'm not supposed to do. God, I'm doing them. For the word of God said, Paul was in a place where the spirit wrestling against the flesh. Come on, the flesh wrestling against the spirit. He said, but I had to forget those things. God, he said, I won't be forgetting, but I'm going to die daily. I will kill myself daily. Are you getting it? At the end of it, I hear Paul run. He wasn't weary. He walked, and he walked, and he walked, and he said, walk. Look at him saying. And he wasn't fainting. I learned that he got wings which I couldn't see. He walked up with wings and looking like an eagle. Not only that, when you reach where an eagle is, you don't see further.
Amen.
The higher you go, it's further you don't see. That's why eagle have to go above to see.
Amen.
When the time comes, he said, thank God that I forget those things that are here. And I reach to God. For there is a crown now laid up for me. Not any other crown, but a righteous one. 1 Peter 17 and 18.
17 and 18. For the time is come that judgment must begin at the house of God.
Yeah. If you don't know that it will start here and not in the world,
right.
It will start with me and it will start with you, and this is the time. Right. Church, what is church good? This church used to be jam-packed. It used to be full. I heard when Chris Paul said something on Friday, some people will never come back here because of what they say. I don't wish. Are you there, church? God's word has come to pass. But they have to forget that and find themselves back into the hands that could only save the soul and set them free. Satan said, don't go back. Don't come back, don't go back. Because he comes to steal and to kill. I watched a man called the prodigal boy. And the prodigal boy began to spare.
deep. The prodigal boy became naked. The prodigal boy had nothing to eat. But the prodigal boy had a mind of his own. The prodigal boy said, no matter how I smell it, no matter how hungry I am, no matter who I fight with, no matter what kind of life I live, or say the righteous life, I'm telling you, it's only one place I know where I'm real life. While I'm sitting in the audience, maybe you might come straight because I'm putting best ring on you. Because you know why? It's good to say sorry. It's good to say thanks. It's good to say forgive me. Because the word of God says it. He said, when you confess with your mouth, nobody else mouth, your mouth, and believe in your heart, He's worthy and just to forgive you. Give him a shout.
Us,
if this judgment thing stands here, tell me what will happen. Read.
What shall the end be to them that obey not the gospel of God?
What shall the end be with them that obey not the gospel? Read.
And if the righteous scarcely be saved,
you tell me,
where shall the ungodly and the sinner appear?
Tell me, church, tell me. Read.
Wherefore, let them that suffer according to the will of God commit the keeping of their souls to Him in well doing.
In what?
In well doing.
We commit we serve because we go get pressure.
But we have to do well.
Amen.
Are we there, children?
Amen.
For the word of God in Peter also says, if God didn't spare the angels that sin in heaven, then I will put them in chains until that day of judgment. Then tell me what I must be.
And I was talking to church.
I was stopping because I don't want to pull up your head too much. Because there's so much more to tell you. Let me tell you this, church. When you leave this place, no daughter ain't going where you were. No son ain't going where you go. No bishop ain't going where you go. No evangelist ain't going where you go. Bishop, what you say? And all of we praising God together? He said you're watching them on the outside. I'm checking out the inside.
Yes.
I know how many of them here. They were just called to the church.
Come on, come on.
But their heart is bitter. So their harvest is big. But it's a very few laborers inside.